in part four of this message, I want to talk to us about walking in the Spirit. All of us must learn to walk in the Spirit in order for us to live this overcoming, victorious life. A life that is overcoming the flesh, the world, and the devil. You know, sometimes people get very confused or they misunderstand what the spirit-filled life is all about. They think if you shout a few hallelujahs and say a little bit in tongues, oh, you're filled with the Spirit. That is a very poor understanding of what walking in the Spirit or living in the Spirit or the spirit-filled life is all about. Because the passages we read today from Romans 8, from Galatians 5, and Ephesians 5 are describing to us life in the Spirit, of walking in the Spirit. Paul uses different terms synonymously. He talks about walk in the Spirit, live in the Spirit, be led by the Spirit, be filled with the Spirit. These are synonymous to the life, the normal Christian life, a life of a person who has the Holy Spirit in him or her and is living out of that, right? And he describes to us, and the key thing that you will see repeated in Romans 8 and Galatians 5 is that when we live in the Spirit or walk in the Spirit, he says, you know, we will crucify the flesh. The flesh will be dead. We will not give in to the things of the flesh. So many of us as believers, we say, you know, how do I overcome these sins? And how do I overcome these temptations? Well, this is the answer. Walk in the Spirit. Some key insights here just to begin with, which we can take from these passages. First of all, we are instructed and empowered to walk in the Spirit. Another important insight we can deduce is walking in the Spirit is necessary to live a life pleasing to God. Then we also said walking in the Spirit leads to life, peace, and righteousness. So, today's sermon, we're going to just answer three questions. What does it mean to walk in the Spirit? That's the first question we want to answer. What does it mean to walk in the Spirit? Second question, how do I do this practically? Now, how can I do this out? How can you and I walk in the Spirit in everyday Christian life? And how do I know if I'm walking in the Spirit? We're just going to answer these three questions. So, what does it mean to walk in the Spirit? To walk in the Spirit is to walk yielded to, under the influence of, in submission to, under the direction of, and by the empowering of the Holy Spirit. It means that regardless of what I'm facing in my body, in my mind, or in my circumstances, I walk yielded to, under the direction, under the influence, under the guidance, and under the empowering of the Holy Spirit. That's walking in the Spirit. So, how do we walk in the Spirit, live in the Spirit, be led by the Spirit, or be filled by the Spirit? How do we do this practically? And I just want to just share some practical things that I do in my life. First of all, we want to stay filled. Number two, think about and pursue what pleases the Holy Spirit. Thirdly, ask the Holy Spirit for help. Number four, speak the word. How can I know if I'm walking in the Spirit? What will be the evidence of that? Paul tells us this. Number one, we will manifest the fruit of the Spirit. Instead of the works of the flesh, that is envy, jealousy, pride, all of those things, contentions and strife. Instead of those things, our life will be full of love, joy, peace, kindness, meekness, self-control, and faith. That's what we will demonstrate. Number two, I will edify others. Paul said in Ephesians 5:19, speaking to one another in psalms, hymns, and spiritual songs. So if I'm filled with the Spirit, I'll be building people up around me, bringing the best out of them, encouraging them, edifying them. Number three, I will be in a place of communion with the Lord. And lastly, number four, we will walk with humility. Ephesians 5:21, submitting to one another in the fear of God. That means you can be 55 years old. Somebody comes to you who's 25. You submit. You say, but I'm older. You are older, of course. No one's questioning your age. But the Bible says, we submit to one another. All of us submit to one another in the fear of God. And that's an expression of the spirit-filled life.